Hey everybody, it's Carlene the Pink Scrapper, and today by request I'm going to show you a tutorial on how to make these cool zipper flowers. This is actually a zipper flower that I got in a rack from someone, and there's no name on it so I can't give you credit, but if this is yours, thank you, because it sent me on a zipper hunt. These are some of the zipper flowers that I've done. This one, these are actually from the thrift store, and I wrapped it around, you know, a piece of paper and used my hot glue gun, and then I put stickles on this one. Here's another one, I just put a pearl in the middle. Here's one that kind of looks a little vintagey. Here's one with a pearl loop and feathers, and then this one looks vintage as well, and you can tell the difference between a new zipper and the old zipper. You can see how much character it can give your flower. And this one is an older zipper as well, so you can see these are the zippers that I got in my thrift store haul, and very shabby chic-y. And you know what else I did is I left some small pieces available so that I could put it on a page, a scrapbook page, as an embellishment. So let me show you how to cut this. Now I would say you need about 18 inches, and this one is 18 inches, but let me show you how to cut this. Now I rolled this all the way down till I'm going to leave it about there so that I can use this in another embellishment. But generally you just leave it zipped up and just cut. And you can cut, I'm using the Tim Holtz scissors, you can totally cut right through this. Not a problem with this scissors. And there you go. So now this can be a cute embellishment and on a scrapbook page. So now I have less than 18 inches here because I left some extra, but I'll show you how I do them. Oh, and I forgot to show you, these are some flowers that I made with my pattern paper from the thrift store, and I'm going to try to do a tutorial on this. So these are just, you know, a couple examples. Let's push those away. And I like to use my 1-inch punch and some scrap paper. And go ahead and punch out your circles. And then you can put a little bit of hot glue down and then go ahead and start your flower. Now you want to roll this so that the zipper's up at the top. And I'm going to show you this one. Oops. So I'm going to roll kind of a loose circle so I can put something in there. And then I'm just going to paste it or glue it right to that spot like that. Let me zoom in. There you go. So there's that. And then you just keep wrapping it around. Now, you can wrap it really tightly or really loosely, whatever you like. And the other thing is you can even twist this. And I think I'm going to do that. If you want something like this, you just keep wrapping and wrapping and wrapping around and gluing, and you get to that point. So for this one, I'm going to give it a little twist. So I'm twisting to the back, and then I'll put a little dot. Oops. Put a little dot, hold it in, wrap it around. Oops. You twist towards the back again. Put a little glue and keep going. It gives it, you know, just a different look. And so you just keep going and twisting. You can see it's giving it a different look. And you can do this same thing with ribbon. One of the best videos I've seen on a ribbon rose is by Donna, and she is 123 card maker. Okay, so you just hold it and you keep twisting, and see, I'm almost done. And I could have probably used a bigger circle for this, but it's okay. It's okay. Like I always say, there's no rules in scrapbooking. You can do totally whatever you want. And so I'm going to put a little bit more glue here, and then I'm going to continue. Now, some people actually put a running stitch on the bottom of your zipper, and you can totally go ahead and do that and try it and see if you like it. For me, it didn't really help too much. And what I mean by that is you just put a basting stitch, which are very large stitches, all the way in the bottom. You can do that with a needle and thread, and then it might help it curl better and fall into the circle shape. So there's my flower. Let's see if I have something to put in the middle. You can take some beads and just stick that in the middle just like that, and I think that's what I'm going to do. For me, it's just what is on my table at the time, and that is what gets used. So we're going to cut that, and we're just going to poke it in there. Ta-da! You can put leaves, you can put bling, you can put a pearl loop like this on there. There's my cute zipper. You can distress it, do whatever you want with it. So I hope you guys like that, and thanks for watching.